Now, in the fourth and section of our lecture, we will talk about some disorders of the Eustachian tube. In this, we will talk about the tubal blockage and adenoids, cleft palate and tubal functions, and then we will also talk about the Down syndrome effect and barotrauma. The tubal blockage. In this, we have the acute tubal blockage. If there is acute tubal block, if the Eustachian tube is blocked, then usually there is absorption of middle ear gases. When the tube is blocked, absorption of middle ear gases takes place, and then this can build negative pressure in the middle ear. So, blockage of the tube, absorption of gases in the middle ear, and this can cause negative pressure in the middle ear. This negative pressure can lead to retraction of the tympanic membrane. This is the tympanic membrane, so it can cause retraction of the tympanic membrane. Then with the retraction of tympanic membrane, there is transudate in middle ear and can be hemorrhage or blood due to prolonged tubal blockage. Then there is, then we have otitis media, middle ear, or middle ear infection is present. So all these changes can occur with the obstruction of Eustachian tube that leads to absorption of gases, negative pressure creation, retraction of tympanic membrane. Then there is, with the retraction, there is accumulation of transudate, and that can be hemorrhagic if there is prolonged tubal blockage. Then there is followed by atelectasis, thick ear, or perforation. Atelectasis occur due to increased pressure on the tympanic membrane and retraction of the tympanic membrane. There can be perforation. Then there is retraction pocket or cholesteatoma. Cholesteatoma is the presence of abnormal cells in the, so all these changes can occur with the blockage of the Eustachian tube. And then there is erosion of incus and stapedial joint, where there is junction between incus and stapedius. Incus and stapedius are the bones or ossicles present in the middle ear. So with the obstruction or blockage of tympanic membrane, all these changes can occur, leading finally to erosion of the incus and stapedius. There is formation of retraction pockets, cholesteatoma, and there is negative pressure in the meatus, middle ear. Next, what's the causes of Eustachian tube obstruction? Causes are, there is upper respiratory tract infection, allergy, sinusitis, nasal polyps, DNS or deviated nasal septum. If the septum of the nose is deflected to one side, usually it leads to more infections and allergies. Hypertrophic adenoids, nasopharyngeal tumor, cleft palate, submucous cleft palate, Down syndrome, and then functional. All these are the different causes that can cause obstruction of the Eustachian tube. Adenoids and Eustachian tube. Adenoids are present close to the Eustachian tube, and when the adenoids, they get bigger and enlarged, it can cause obstruction of the Eustachian tube. Cleft palate, and again tubal function. Cleft palate is the opening in the soft palate of the baby, so there is a hole or gap in the palate. The tubal function is disturbed in cleft palate patients. How? Due to abnormalities of torus tuberius, which shows high elastin density, making the tube difficult to open. So, high elastin density, they keep the tube closed because of elastic recoil, and there is difficulty in opening the Eustachian tube. And then another is tensor velli palatini muscle does not insert into the torus tuberius in 40% cases of cleft palate, and where it does insert, its function is poor. So muscle is not properly inserted also, and when it is not inserted properly, it cannot contract properly to open the Eustachian tube. That's the two main reason in the cleft palate that leads to the abnormality of the Eustachian tube functioning. Then Down syndrome also affects the tubal function. In this function of Eustachian tube is defectively possibly due to poor tone of tensor villi palatini muscle and abnormal shape of nasopharynx. Down syndrome, usually you can say this is the abnormal shape of the nasopharynx, and due to poor tone of tensor villi palatini muscles that cause poor opening of the Eustachian tube. Then children with this syndrome are prone to frequent otitis media or otitis media with effusion. Also, they are more prone to infections also because of abnormal shape of the nasopharynx. Ascent of the infections is easy. So children with Down syndrome, they are more prone to infections as compared to other children. Then barotrauma. Barotrauma is due mainly the affects the functioning of the Eustachian tube due to abnormal pressure differences between the outside and in the middle ear, and this even sometimes can lead to fluid and blood discharge from the Eustachian tube because of the high pressure differences. Thank you for watching sqadia.com.